Much worse. You're gonna live. So, tell me what you've been feeling.
I've been getting these headaches. They started a couple weeks ago, right after my graduation.
Mm-hmm.
But they get so bad sometimes, I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Well, you've had these before. Okay. Well, we'll run some tests. Hmm? Okay.
Yes, Mrs. Weems. My assistant, Audrey Sims, submitted the bill to your insurance company the day you came in. Yes, well, perhaps they misplaced it. All right, will you give us a call if you have any problems? All right, goodbye. Will 2 weeks from today be all right?
Is she okay?
Audrey, it's her father. He just passed away.
Special delivery for the lady of the house.
Thank you.
There's something else.
Something else? Yeah. What? Go downstairs and open up, and you better get dressed.
I thought I was dressed.
I see she has you on your knees again.
Morning, Mrs. J.
What did you do this time? Spill your milk?
Good to see you, too.
Why don't you come over for a haircut? Maybe I can give you something different.
Morning, Natalie.
Good morning, Olivia. I was just telling your son that he should find someone new to give him his haircuts.
Tea?
Oh, lovely. Think about it. Here's your mail.
Oh, thank you.
I love that part. Listen. I don't know why most conductors insist on playing the adagietto as if it were meant for a funeral parlor. Mala composed it as a love song to his wife, Alma.
Really? I didn't know that. Oh, kitty, 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 kitty.
Olivia, not another stray. Why do you cater to those filthy rodents?
I want to show you something. Tom designed a new card.
Really?
Someday we'll sell cards by Tom Hendricks, and people will ask for them. We'll name them after the shop, From the Heart. Tom? I was just telling Mrs. J that someday we'll have an entire display of your cards, and all the big companies will want you to write for them, right?
Right.
Right.
Very nice. Very romantic.
And we could enclose the patio and turn it into an office.
Is there any mail for me?
Just bills. Oh.
Okay. Oh.
Olivia, when was the last time Tom went out with a girl?
I don't know. Why? What do you mean?
Well, he's not exactly a little boy anymore. He's a big boy with big boy's interests. Such as? Olivia, you may have lost interest in sex, but it's only natural that Tom should want to play hide the bone now and then.
How dare you talk about my son that way? You have a foul opinion of human nature.
If you don't like my friendship, I can go.
Natalie, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have any real true friends. Sit down. Stay. Have your tea. Darn that radio. It's got a wire loose in the plug or something.
Dear Dad, tonight I want to sit quietly with you and remember the child inside of me. I think of him like a morning star, full of life, but destined to fade away in a pale blue sky. Is that what it means to grow up? To let go of your dreams? I feel like it's time to break away, to be on my own. Sometimes, like ghosts, those loved and lost seem never to let go. But God absolves the haunted heart, say wiser men I know.
Listen to this. His hand worked along the warm flesh of her thigh, reaching for the dark secret place where no man had...
I don't know why you read such trash.
I can fantasize, can't I? Besides, what else do I have to occupy my time?
Well, you could be grateful for the things that you do have. Mm-hmm.
Such as?
You have money.
You think so, do you?
Well, I just assumed.
Well, people aren't always what they seem. And money's not that much help when you're all alone in the middle of the night. You have this place. You have Tom.
Well, believe me, Natalie, you wouldn't want to trade places with me. Things are not at all what they seem.
I don't know about that. I'd love having something that belongs to me. A place where I belong.
By the way, Mrs. Stallings down the street? Well, she invited me to join her bridge club meetings on Wednesday nights. Maybe we can go together.
You don't want to play bridge with a bunch of old women. Getting fat, eating cheesecake, spending hours talking about bladder control. Or cancer. Listen, you tell Mrs. Stallings that you and I are going to have fun on Wednesday, just the two of us.
Okay.
Doctor's office, hold please. I'm sorry, hold on please. Doctor's office.
Hi.
Okay. Oh, hi.
I think you just hung up on everybody.
Oh. Well, they're sick enough, they'll call back, right? I guess.
Yeah.
Marion's out today. I'm the only one here. That card you sent?
Huh?
It was very considerate. Did you make it?
Yeah.
It was beautiful.
Thanks. I'm just glad you're okay.
Thanks. I'll let him know that you're here.
Okay. I'll watch the phone.
Okay.
We could run some more tests, Tom, but I don't think that's necessary.
You think I'm making it up, or?
Oh, no, of course not. No, I believe that your headaches and nausea are very real. Well, my guess is that they're being caused by something else. How's your mother? I mean, is she taking her medication?
What does that got to do with me?
Does she know you're here?
No.
Do you mind if I ask why not?
I just didn't want her to worry.
Maybe you need to start worrying about yourself. Oh, by the way, a friend of mine asked me to give this to you.
Thanks.
What in the hell is this? Where's the rest of it?
There is no more.
Don't lie to me, mister. Don't you lie to me.
I'm not lying.
Keys. You're grounded.
Audrey?
No, this is your father. Just a moment.
Yes, I was 16 years old, in the back seat of my French teacher's car, with the windows all fogged up. I was going to say, in love. Do you remember your first Prince Charming? I don't believe in fairy tales anymore, Olivia. The witch wins, the princess dies.
What about your husband? Surely you felt something for him.
I married him for his money. He married me because he needed an ornament to dress up his double chin and his beady eyes. We said I love you, but people don't always mean what they say.
What about you?
What did you get out of your happy marriage?
Well, what did I get? I got the most beautiful baby boy in the whole wide world. And I remember the first time that I ever held him in my arms.
Oh,
I love him so much.
Maybe too much. Are you all right? Do you want me to come in with you for a while?
No. I'll be fine, thanks. Tommy?
Left feet?
Something like that. Oh, God. Everyone looked like
that. This reminds me of my prom.
Yeah.
Except you're much cuter than my prom date.
Yeah, sure.
Mr. Hendricks.
I went to prom, and it was really bad.
But really?
She didn't do as good as you. She couldn't even get me on the dance floor. I hid by the punch bowl. Prettier than feels too.
I think we should go get something to drink.
Oh.
Okay. Come on. Great dancer.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Well, thanks to you. So would you like to do something this weekend?
I'd love to, but I'm gonna be busy. I'm moving.
Moving where?
I got this great apartment downtown above the old firehouse. It's near the university. I'm starting there in September.
That's great.
I don't know what I want to be when I grow up. I just want to start. Do you know what I mean? What's this all about?
Just drive.
So, what does your mother think about you leaving the nest?
She's the one pushing me. I was worried about leaving her alone. But she says it's the best thing for me to do, to stick to my goals. It's funny, but sometimes I feel like my father's telling me the same thing. Like he's still with me.
My father died when I was 3. I don't remember him really, but sometimes I feel like he's with me, too. I never told this to anybody before, but I write to him in my journal. I just tell him about how me and my mother are doing and how much I miss him. Pretty strange, huh?
I don't think so. So, what do you want to be when you grow up?
Oh, I should be hearing any day from William Carey University in LA. They have a really good creative writing program, so I think I got a chance at a scholarship. Be a real writer.
That's exciting. L.A., huh?
Yeah, that's where we lived until my dad died. Actually, I would have applied earlier. But my mother, she had a breakdown. So I had to stay with her until she got better. But now I need to do what's right for me.
You must be Audrey. I'm Olivia Hendricks, Tom's mother, and I just talked to your mother on the phone. Thank goodness you told her where you were going.
Hi, Mrs. Hendricks. We were just talking about you.
Is that why my ears were burning? Tommy, I thought maybe you forgot, but you know how important tomorrow is? All those new orders coming in.
Mom, I know. I'll be home soon.
Well, I really think you should come now. You know how early that delivery truck comes? The morning has gold in its mouth, Audrey, but a young man can't find it if his eyes are filled with sleep.
Mother, it's okay. I'll wake up early.
Tommy, come on. I'm sure Audrey will understand.
Mother?
My goodness, look at the time. Look.
Mother, that's enough! I said I'd do it!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You leave him alone.
Tommy? Tommy.
Hey, hey.
Take it easy. Take it easy.
Can you open?
Yes. I'm in.
Just do.
Get him some water.
No water. Thank you.
You're in a relation to the woman who comes.
What woman?
She always comes on his birthday. On the headstone. The kid's birthday is the same as mine.
What does she look like?
I never got a good look at her. She'll be here next month. That's for sure. It's our birthday.
Mother? Mother, open the door! Mother!
Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Chloe Birch. I'm with the admissions office at the William Carey University in Southern California. Dear Jesus, was that a temblor?
A temblor?
Earthquake. It felt at least like a 4.6.
No, it was just our old faulty plumbing.
We don't have temblors here, Ms. Birch, or any other biblical afflictions. I hope you won't hold that against us.
Oh, no, of course not. In any case, I'm here attending a conference on future trends in admissions policies. And I thought I'd skip the round table this morning. Stop by and see if Tom Hendricks has received any of our letters.
Frankly, the deadline for accepting our scholarship was yesterday.
But when I didn't hear anything back, I wanted to make sure. At first, I wondered if we got the address wrong.
It's a little bit embarrassing for me to have to tell you, Miss Birch. He's staying home. The University of Rochester has offered him a full scholarship, and he's accepted it.
I see. But I was under the impression that we were Tom's first choice.
Well, he wanted to go to your school. Southern California looked a lot less sunny to him when he discovered just how appreciated he was right in his own backyard. I'm afraid that you've paid us a visit for nothing.
Perhaps not. Is Tom here?
No. He's visiting friends. Why?
I'm prepared to offer him a full scholarship. Mrs. Hendricks. The tea?
Oh, excuse me.
In any case, I'll need to see Tom and get his signature on these papers by tonight. The university is a real stickler about deadlines. If we miss this one. Oh. Thank you.
Briefcase.
Ow! 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 Ow!
I'll skip tea today.
Dear Dad, Mother and I are hurting each other bitterly. It's as if we're tearing open the skin that wraps us, not struggling to a new birth, but destroying ourselves.
What are you writing?
Go ahead. Read it.
These
letters to my father.
Why are you doing this?
It's for me. It's just for me.
He's dead, Tom. Dead and buried. You have to let go of him. And I'm going to help you.
I was told my mother's here. Olivia Hendricks!
Tom!
What happened? What happened?
I don't know. She called and asked, did I want a cup of tea? When she didn't answer the door, I let myself in. I found her collapsed on the floor.
She's alive?
Yes, and that's all I know.
Oh, God. I did this. It's my fault.
No,
I did.
Don't.
It's my fault.
Don't blame yourself.
Where is she? I need to see her.
No, she's all right. Stay with me.
I need to see her.
The doctors can handle this.
I need to see my mother.
You can't go in there. Wait.
Mother! Let me go!
She's
mother!
She's asleep. She's under sedation.
Are you all right? I find your sincerity deplorably nauseating.
Mr. Hendricks?
What is it? What happened?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to startle you. Please, sit down. I'm Dr. Chase, head of psychiatrics here at St. Dominic's.
How is she?
Your mother's going to be fine.
Can I see her, please?
I've consulted with her physician.
Dr. Baden?
Yes. And we feel she should stay here for several days.
Why?
She's in a total state of denial about her attempted suicide. And she's threatened several members of the staff.
Please, can I see her?
I don't think that would be a good idea. With her history of depression, I think your mother would make more progress if you didn't see her for a while. Now, I can't prevent you from seeing her if that's what you want. But both myself and Dr. Baden believe that's the best course. But there is a problem. I've explained to your mother that we need to keep her under observation here tonight at the hospital. But come tomorrow, she will not voluntarily stay.
You want me to commit her?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello, this is Audrey Sims. Is Tom in?
No, he isn't.
I was calling to see how his mother's doing. Excuse me, but who am I speaking to?
How'd you get in?
You left your key in the door.
She's all I've got.
That's not true.
love you.
What are you doing at my son's grave?
She pays me to do this. I come here once a year and bring flowers and a card to the grave.
Who pays you?
I don't know. She put the cash with a card.
Where did you get those clothes?
She sent them to me. She said I have to wear them.
Where are they from?
I don't know.
Where's the card from?
There's no return address.
Let go.
He got a gun.
Everything checks out. L.A. says you're one of theirs.
My service revolver? Can I go?
Your friends at LAPD are worried. Seems you got some bad news about your health and disappeared. You're supposed to be in the hospital.
Yeah, well, I'm through with doctors. 7 years of being poked and stabbed is enough.
What are you doing in San Diego County?
My son is buried here.
What's that got to do with the woman you attacked?
I thought she was my wife.
Yeah, that's all I need. More domestic bullshit. Maybe you should get away from things for a while. Take a vacation.
Vacation, yeah.
Yeah.
I've been thinking about going back east. Rochester.
You got family there?
It's me.
Oh, hi. Up is the elevator.
Okay.
they're beautiful. Thanks. Come on in.
Wow. Ooh, wow.
Isn't it great?
Big. It's so beautiful. This is a view? Oh,
the city?
I'm jealous. This is great. What are you painting? Purple?
It's not purple. Come on. It's fuchsia.
Fuchsia. I see. It's beautiful. So Dr. Chase said she's finally cooperating. He thinks maybe I can see her soon. It's been almost a week.
Dr. Baden says she's in good hands. But you know what I really want to know?
What?
How you are.
Good.
Good? What does that mean? Tell me. What's good?
Good.
No, oh, he needs to take a drink first.
No. I was just gonna say that good. This is good. Being here with you is good. You listen when I talk. You care about what I'm thinking. You make me feel like I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be.
Olivia, are you with me?
Yes.
Tell me more about when Tommy was growing up. Did you ever leave him alone?
No. It was just the two of us.
Didn't you ever need to?
You should watch the news more often.
You were afraid something bad might happen.
What mother isn't? You never stop worrying. Never.
Was your mother that way with you?
She was a good mother. I remember when I turned 5, she made me a birthday cake in the shape of a heart. And my father kissed me after dinner. And he said he was going to get a cigar and paper the newsstand. We waited for him. And we began to worry. We thought maybe he'd been in an accident or something. And that's when she found that he'd taken his suitcase.
He never came back.
No.
Tell me about your husband. Where did you live?
California.
How did you meet?
He was a policeman. And my card shop was on his beat. And he used to stop in every day and say hello.
How did he die? Olivia, how did your husband die?
He committed suicide.
Do you have any idea why?
I suppose all of us have our dark side.
Go on.
I've lost everything I ever loved. Tommy's all I have left.
Olivia, you're not losing Tom. You're not losing his love.
I didn't want to hurt him. I don't want to hurt him.
What do you think would have happened if you had died? Did you really want to take your life?
No. I wanted.
What? Olivia, what is it? What is it?
I didn't try to kill myself. It was a lie. I just was afraid I'd lose him. It's the truth. You can't believe me.
I believe you, Olivia. I ordered blood tests the night they brought you in. You had a belly full of vitamin C. No more lies, Olivia. I can't help you unless you tell me everything. Are you ready to tell me the truth?
Yes! Please let me see my son.
Dr. Chase. Dr. Chase.
So, how did it go?
I can't believe it. She seems so much better. I told her about the girl I was seeing, and you know what she said?
What?
She said she's happy for me. Happy I found someone I care for.
That's good. She's made a lot of progress. But she also has a long way to go.
So, when do you think she can come home?
I'm going to let your mother go home in a couple of days. But, Tom, it's very important we continue her therapy after she leaves. Twice, maybe three times a week.
Thank you.
the only picture I have of my father. I found it when I was a kid. I was playing in my mother's room, and she had it hidden in her dresser.
How old are you?
4 or 5? I'm not sure.
Can we go higher?
This thing's a little rickety.
That's what's good.
Welcome home, Mother. So, what do you think?
Oh, it's interesting.
It's fuchsia. I thought the place needed a facelift.
Yeah.
You want some tea?
Yeah.
I got a new flavor.
Okay.
It's from Tibet. I'll put the water on.
Thank you, Mrs. Stalling, so much.
You know that invitation for our bridge club still stands. I do wish you'd join us.
Well, I'd love to, if I only had the time. Thank you.
You change your mind.
Bye.
Give us some tea.
Thank you. I'd love some. It's good to be back.
It's good to have you back.
Thank you.
2 weeks today.
Is that all?
In some ways, it's like you were never gone. Except for that new color in there. A tabubescent for our taste, don't you think?
Changed.
I want to pick up Audrey.
And when will you be home?
We're having dinner here tonight. Mother's cooking her famous pot roast. You need anything?
No, I'm all set.
Okay. Oh, by the way, Dr. Chase's office just called to reschedule your appointment.
I'll take care of it.
You promise?
Okay.
Well, things have changed. Dinner with the girlfriend. And I'm not invited. I'm offended.
I can't stand that thing. I think it's time to get a new radio.
What
What do you mean, things have changed?
She's stealing him away from you.
They're just friends.
Oh? Oh! Well, just friends, of course. That explains the night that she was here when you were gone. All night. I'm just looking out for your interests.
Hello, Olivia. Kids are playing ball at Kearney Field tonight. It was on the way. Hope you don't mind my stopping by.
No, not at all.
Are you all right?
Oh, well, I feel kind of silly. I was just watching an old movie, having a good cry, as they say.
Is Tom home?
No, I don't know where he is.
Do you have a minute? Pot roast?
Yes.
It smells great.
Do you take sugar?
Yes.
Cream?
No, thank you.
No. Here you are.
You know why I'm here, Olivia. Our arrangement was for you to see me twice a week. You haven't been in once. You haven't returned my calls. We have unfinished business, Olivia. Your husband, Tom's father, never committed suicide. I checked with the Bureau of Records in Los Angeles. There is no death certificate for a Benjamin Wilson.
You have nothing to do with this!
Olivia, I want to help you.
Does Tom know? Did you tell Tom?
No.
I want you out of my house. Now!
If your husband is alive, Tom has a right to know.
You're trying to take him from me.
Olivia, I want you to come with me now.
Thank you.
Olympia. Please. Please.
I just couldn't stop burping and farting. I farted in the morning and I burped at night. So I slept for 3 days. I heard voices. I spoke in tongues.
So I said to the doctor, if you want me to stop smoking, you'll have to come up with a better solution than the patch. I need something in the mouth. Not taped to my skin.
Mother, what took you so long?
Olivia, darling, I was just telling them how you insisted on going shopping at the last moment.
Hello, Mrs. Hendricks. These are for you. Huh?
What did you buy at the grocery?
Well, I guess they didn't have the sweet green peppers that she wanted after all, did they? Olivia, you are the Picasso of pot roasts.
What are you doing here?
I thought you could use my help.
I don't need your help.
Oh, I think you do. Did you enjoy your drive this evening? Do you keep the trays in the pantry? Olivia, by the way, that gentleman caller you had earlier? I didn't see him leave. What did you do? Sneak him out the back way, huh? Oh. Natalie. There, there. What's done is done. I'm here now. And have you noticed how little Audrey Sunshine has the annoying habit of being both pretty and young at the same time? Oh, poor Tom, he doesn't stand a chance.
Mother? Is that bottle of Chianti still in the basement?
What?
Chianti.
Oh, no. I accidentally knocked it over the other day. It broke.
I think there's another red down there.
No, wait. You know, why don't we have that beautiful bottle of white Zinfandel that we had the other night for dinner? Here it is. Tom, would you get the wine glasses? And, Natalie, would you be so kind as to finish setting the table?
With pleasure. Most women prefer a white Zinfandel. It's sweet.
Mother, why did you invite her here? It was just supposed to be the three of us.
Can I help?
Sure.
Miss Hendricks, you have a lovely home.
Thank you. You hold this. Now.
Tom's a very special person. You must be very proud of him.
Yes, I am.
I know you care about him a lot. I was noticing some of the lovely antique pieces that you have around the house, and I thought that maybe sometime we could go antiquing.
So, how did you meet our boy, Tom?
Well, I was working at Dr. Baden's office this summer, and Tom came in a few weeks ago.
I see.
My father has passed away recently.
I'm sorry.
And when Tom found out, he sent me the most beautiful card. He made it himself.
Certainly sounds like our Tom. What a flair you have. Come now, Tom. Come on. Don't make me beg. Come on.
Tom.
Happy hour's over.
Excuse me, Miss Sims. Have you ever been in my home before? I want to know if you have ever been in my home before. I've been watching you, the way you move, the way you look around, and it's as though this isn't your first time here.
Well, have you?
You fucking bitch. Ah!
Tell the truth, dear.
Well, the truth is that I have been here before. Is there something else that you want to ask me?
No, no. Ask me, Mother. I'll tell you what you want to know. I love her. Is that plain enough for you? I love you. Now let's get the hell out of here.
Don't get involved in my life, Miss Sims.
It's my life she's involved with, Mother, not yours. I exist, Mother. I'm my own fucking person. I This is my hand. See? I eat with it, I write with it, and when I touch with it, I can feel. Without you, I don't need you to breathe for me, to think for me, to feel for me. It's my life, Mother. Let me live my fucking life.
You won't be able to stop him this time.
Don't you tell me what I can and cannot do.
Fine. Then I'll just leave you here all alone so you can figure it out all by yourself.
Good evening and welcome to Eyewitness News. I'm Pat Michaels. The week-long disappearance of a prominent Rochester psychiatrist has triggered an around-the-clock police search. Dr. William Chase, head of psychiatry at St. Dominic's Hospital, was last seen leaving his home on Saturday. Dr. Chase is described as 5'11", 175 pounds, with blue eyes and silver-brown hair. He's 51 years old. Anyone with information is urged to call the Missing Persons Unit. 396-1212. In other news, a local Rochester gun shop owner was held up today. Apparently, the bandit made off with 15 hand...
You know you gotta see her again. Work things out.
I know.
You have to resolve this.
Cuts your cleaning time in half.
Hi, everyone. I'm Susie Brandon. And that's right. I hate to do floors, right?
Pity. That's I can't imagine so you doing anything else.
There's a revolutionary new way to clean floors. That's right. It's called Smart Mop.
Hello?
Natalie. It's me. I need your help.
So let's bring
Olivia. What a surprise.
Are you sure he's in there with her?
Yes. The only thing that I'm not sure about is you.
What does that mean?
I told you what I want. Tell me something. What is it you want?
I want what you have. I want the shop, your life, everything. We can share 50-50. Partners in everything. Listen. Get a lawyer to draw up the papers. I want them tomorrow. If you don't, I'll tell the police what you're up to. And don't try to do anything to hurt me. I have a signed statement in my safety deposit box. Do as I say. I give you my word. I won't tell a soul. You know why? Because we're friends, Olivia. And that's what friends are for.
It's Olivia.
You know her?
Olivia Hendricks.
Hendricks?
She owns a card shop over on Avion Avenue. It's called From the Heart.
Thank you.
What's she done?
Now, the only question left is how. There's a gun, of course. It's noisy, I know. But it's certainly a lot easier than a knife. With a knife, you've got to stick it in, maybe several times, and then there's all that blood. I know. Gouging out the eyes, cutting off the tongue. Messy. Very biblical.
Hello, ladies. Big Al here at your service. President and owner of Big Al's Wholesale. Family run and owned since 1952. Can I help you find something today?
A radio.
A radio? Hey, I grew up on radio. Remember the good old days? God, I love those old murder mysteries. The Shadow, Thriller, Murder at Midnight.
How about strangulation?
Strangulation. Strangulation. Was that what Boris called it?
There's nothing more poetic than taking someone's life with your own hands. Of course, the purists would disagree. Poison is their cup of tea.
Boy, that must have been a good one. You remembered all the lines.
I'll take this one.
It's me, Natalie.
Yes?
It's your mother. She's terribly distraught. You should get over here right away.
I'm busy.
Fine. At least if anything happens, my conscience is clear. Now I'll write him a note. Tell him we've gone for a walk. Get your coat on.
That was Mrs. J. She says my mother's distraught.
I think you should go.
No. No.
What is it?
Listen, the first night when my mother was in the hospital, Mrs. J came in my room. I was upset. She wanted me to...
It's okay.
It wasn't the first time she tried.
That doesn't matter. What matters now is that you do what's right.
Come on.
Mother?
Filled a tub.
I waited 9 months for that day to arrive. And oh God, when it finally did, it was a miracle. All those memories. But I can't remember anymore. They're gone. You stole them.
I did anything to hurt you. Oh, please.
Please, please forgive me, please.
Natalie warned me about you.
Natalie. Mrs. Hendricks, Tom told me that when you were in the hospital, that Mrs. J came in his room. She tried to have sex with him.
No. No. No.
Don't you see that she's the one causing all these problems? Mrs. Hendricks, please give me the gun.
What color are these walls? What color are these walls?
They're fuchsia.
Thank you. Benjamin. Benjamin. I'm your father.
Yes. No, we're down here in San Diego on vacation. It's the Ogden Pharmacy.
Thanks, but Tommy, don't stand so close to the TV. You'll hurt your eyes.
Don't open that door, son. It's suicide.
Bing, bing, bing.
Can you hold the baby?
Come here, Ben.
I'll get him ready.
Bing, bing.
Your brother's name was Tom. Your name is Ben. Benjamin, after me. It was an accident. A tragic accident. She blamed me. One day I came home from work and you were gone. She'd taken everything. That was 19 years ago.
She told me you were dead.
Oh, God, you frightened me. I didn't hear you come in, Olivia.
There was a man. I saw him snooping around, and he went around the back. He followed Tom when he left. It could have been the police. Did they go over to Audrey's? I mean, did anyone see you? Did you talk to anyone? Olivia, don't lie to me now, or I swear that I will drag you down to hell with me. I don't have time. Now, we gotta get our story straight. Now, this is what happened. I called Tom, and I told him about your delicate condition. But then we decided we wanted to go for a walk, so I wrote him a note that you were tense, that you needed fresh air. Then we went up Pine Street, and then over to the park. Now, do you think you can remember that, hmm? Can you? Can you remember that? Answer me, you stupid bitch! Oh! Benjamin.
Hello, Olivia.
It's been a long time.
A long time.
I'm trying to remember. Isn't that funny? All those years trying to forget. Now, I can't. Tommy.
Tommy. You shouldn't have left me, Tommy. You should have stayed here, inside of me. You'd have been safe here. I could have protected you. My Ben.
You better get dressed, Tommy. It's almost time to open up.
I love you, Mother.
I know.
It's okay. Ah!
Expression, the smile you gave me, the way you looked when we met. It's easy to remember, but so hard to forget. I hear you whisper, I'll always love you. I know it's over. It's easy to remember, but so hard to forget.
Mm-hmm.